I'm Jill Johnsen. I'm one of the hematologists at BloodWorks and the Washington Center for Bleeding Disorders and at the University of Washington. I care for patients with bleeding disorders, and I do research on the causes of why we have variation in how we clot our blood and why do we have trouble with our blood groups and transfusion. So I work at the intersection between giving clinical care and trying to better understand why people have disease and putting the two together to make both sides better. The interesting thing after COVID is I now work from home a lot, which means my 13-year-old daughter hears what I do. She never really knew what I did before. And that has been an interesting mirror to hold up to my life, is what your kid has overheard that you do for your job. She started asking some very good scientific questions that have prompted me to say, I don't know a whole lot, which has been a really useful exercise to bring in this new viewpoint of sort of a very friendly spectator, but one who hasn't been formally trained in science, who's listening in on lab meeting and kind of getting it. Which, you know, I think that's true of lots of kids. You know, I think all kids are scientists. They come out being inquisitive. I mean, if you've been around a three-year-old and you haven't been asked why something happens in the past 10 minutes, you have to better check that everything's okay, you know? Kids are constantly asking why. They're putting together cause and effect. They're actually generating little hypotheses, and they're pushing on boundaries. They're pushing on physical things to see, what does this do? You know, does it do something? And I think a lot of science is getting to be a kid about asking these questions and still being curious and still wanting to figure out how things work. And I think everyone has that in them. Everyone's a scientist who's still curious, who still wants to structure a question and see if they can figure out the answer. So science isn't just for people who have letters after their name. And one of them turns out to be a 13-year-old in my house, and that's been a new experience. But it's definitely made dinner very different than it used to be before.